session. What more can I tell you?
Hello everyone and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Sasha and I normally do videos with my daughter Arella, who is not in today's video. Actually, my cat is in this video, and it's funny because in my last relaxation video, she was featured. I'm going to be sharing tips on how to increase your breast milk supply if you are experiencing a low supply and want to be making more milk than you are right now. So if you are interested in that, then continue watching. Starting with tip number one, if you are pumping or breastfeeding, just make sure to do this more often. So I would suggest with my breastfeeding moms, after you're done feeding baby, go onto the pump and pump for like 10 minutes and remove any extra milk that's there, and it will send the signals to your body that you need more milk and the baby is drinking more. You'll actually end up creating more milk, and this is a really great way to give your body those signs. If you are an exclusive pumper, just make sure you are pumping more frequently. So don't let 2 hours pass where you're not pumping. And if you can and you have the ability to do so, I would recommend pumping more frequent than that. So anytime really you feel like, okay, I can pump right now, go onto your pump. If you are a stay-at-home mom, this is really convenient. I personally had that advantage, so I was able to pump anytime I had that free time, and it really helped create a lot more milk, and again sends the signs to your body that you need to make more milk because more is coming out. That brings me on to the next topic, which is power pumping. So there are many different schedules. I'm going to insert a picture right here so you can see an example of one. This is pumping for 20 minutes, taking the pump off, resting 5 minutes, and then pumping again for 10 minutes, taking the pump off, resting for 10 minutes, and then pumping for 20 minutes, and so on. You can create your own pumping schedules and go from there, or you can search up so many different ones on Google, on Pinterest, there's pages on Instagram. There are just so many different pumping schedules you can look at and follow if you are new to that, and I would just recommend adding pumping into your schedule anytime you could though, because that would be better. The more often you're taking it out, the more you're gonna make. Number three, you want to eat lactation bites, so anything that will help your body create more milk. There are lots of different recipes that you can find online, or you can make your own different foods, so putting things like oatmeal and stuff like that into little bite-sized balls, eating that, fueling your body with the food, so making sure you're actually eating because the baby is drinking from you, all your nutrients are, you know, going into your milk and feeding baby, so you want to make sure that you are also giving yourself that energy in eating foods and drinking your fluids and water. And another good thing that helps boost your milk supply is Gatorade and Powerade, and I learned that the electrolytes in there actually helps to create more milk. So certain things that you eat, it can help do that. And if you Google things, you can find other ones that I probably don't know about. I know Gatorade, Powerade, oatmeal. Those are the three things that I'm aware of, but there are many other out there. They have lactation bites that you can purchase at your different grocery stores, online. Just check them out, and it's different with everybody. So a certain lactation cookie that I might try might not work for another mom. So see what works for you and go from there. Another thing is adding in supplements or extra vitamins. So there are herbs and stuff like that that you can take that will help increase milk supply. And this goes back to like a long time where they found natural herbs and stuff to put in their teas and just taking them plain, and it helped them create more milk. So fennel seeds, fenugreek, and blessed thistle. These are the three herbs that I know help produce more breast milk, and it just puts like that extra boost that you need to help you make more. Sometimes you'll experience like a really big letdown because much more milk is coming down at once, and then your pump session goes from 1 ounce to 3 ounces very fast. A lot of these different supplements help to boost your supply. There is the mother's milk tea as well. I find that one is really helpful. I know, for example, my sister, she actually drinks 2 tea bags in her tea, and I've seen some recipes online where moms will put them into like a large container and then make like a cold tea out of that and then put it in the fridge and then just keep drinking the mother's milk tea. So everything all together will help you create much more milk, and I would say don't just try one thing, but adding them all together will help you make so much more milk, probably double your milk supply. And just being consistent with it, I know it's a lot of work, but it's something that's worth it. You're trying to feed your baby breast milk, and some of us are not lucky to have that supply. And it's unfortunate because, like, we want our bodies to do what they need to do, and then they don't. So we need the help, and there's others out there that go through the same problem. So it's really nice to be able to ask for that help and know that there are ways to actually fix that problem. There's a solution, so you don't have to suffer with low supply forever. And just being consistent with everything and knowing that you want to make the milk, that's something that you are, you know, passionate about, I would say, because it does take a lot of time and energy to put your body into that mode of making more milk if you are experiencing a low supply. And after doing it for a while, your body will be used to that, like, milk capacity storage, you know, and it will be making that much milk. So when you're pumping, instead of getting 1 ounce or 2 ounces per session, now you're getting 6 ounces. And that's great because then you can cut down the pumps that you need in between, or even continue pumping the same, storing it. And it just helps you because you have more now, like, you don't have to worry about pumping and all that and feeding and stuff like that. So another thing that I know helps with increasing breast milk supply is coconut water. This was interesting to me because I didn't know that, and it helps with increasing breast milk supply. So I would say give it a try, and it's tasty if you like that. I love coconut water, so for me it was really easy to drink, and I found it helped me personally. But I was doing all of these things together, so I'm not sure exactly which ones helped, but I think doing it all together and being super consistent with it helped make the milk. And yeah, that's what I want to tell you guys, because if I could make it and, like, I really had no milk, like, I have hope that there's so many other moms out there who are struggling with low breast milk supply can become overproducers. Like, you guys can make enough milk to feed your baby and then store it aside, and that's a great feeling. So yeah, another tip is hand expressing. So in the shower, just, you know, squeezing the extra milk that you have out. When you're pumping, making sure to massage. There's different massages that you can look up online, and that helps, like the kneading and stuff like that, to help break down the little milk cells and push it out there. And when you get the milk going out there, then other milk will start forming and stuff like that. Especially if you have, like, your milk coming in the beginning and there's, like, those lumps underneath here, you can really feel, like, the milk up in your armpit, and kneading it down gets all of the milk out, making sure to get everything out, and then yeah, emptying them completely. And your breasts, actually, they're never completely empty, so you will always see milk coming out, but just trying to get, like, as much as you can. And then when you see, like, very little drops or, like, little breaks in between the drops, then you know I've emptied it as much as I can. We're gonna wait a bit and then get back to this when we get back to it, which is probably in the hour or so, because you want to be consistent. On to the next one. This is skin to skin contact. So keeping your baby close to you and having that touch and the feel. A lot of the times they might suckle and still, you know, play with the nipple and stuff. This helps stimulate your breast and getting that signal again to your body that you want to make more milk. And especially, like, if you have your baby kind of suckling and then, like, going back and forth from, you know, left to right, it will create those signs and your body will actually might start leaking and stuff like that. So having that skin to skin contact really tells your body, like, okay, my baby is close by and they're trying to eat and I need to feed them. So it's just a natural instinct that your body wants to make milk to feed your baby, and it'll do that. So have your baby close, take your shirt off, have baby take their shirt off, maybe in just a diaper, and laying there for a little bit. This is really nice in the rocking chair, laying in the bed, if you wear the baby wrap. Just having that close skin-to-skin contact will really help you increase that breast milk supply. Now, that's all the tips that I can think of that would help you. The main point is taking the milk out so that your body is making room to make more milk, and frequently taking it out. So a lot of the times you'll see if babies are cluster feeding, this is because they want your body to know that, okay, I'm eating more and I'm gonna be taking a lot more milk out. So I'm not gonna be okay with that 1 ounce that you're giving me. I need 3 ounces. And from constantly feeding, where you're feeding them like every 20 minutes or every 5 minutes, and you're like, the baby won't stop, they're actually trying to tell your body to make more milk. So doing that with your pump and manually, you know, by yourself without baby or the help of baby, this would definitely help. A lot of the times breastfed babies will just start nursing like that. So you can put your baby on and get them to nurse for a little bit and remove that milk. So yeah, that brings us to the end of today's video. I really hope it helps a lot of you guys struggling with low milk supply. I know I definitely did, and it made me feel really sad for a long time because I wanted to feed her the best milk and I was super determined and I did it. I made sure I pumped, I stayed consistent for few months. Like, it was hard work, but it was worth it. And I would say if you want to make breast milk, then you know the feeling and you'll keep trying and doing what it takes. And after you feel content and you know your heart's full, you can stop doing that and pump and feed your baby as you feel your body will kind of have the milk capacity that you need. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, please check out our other videos. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we will see you in the next one. Bye.